Yes, to the bar to bring your best that you can produce. Your eyes up until you see Christ. Don't fuss around and don't suffer in silence. Before I continue the presentation, I'd like to, you know, big up a few people. Well, I know that there's a certain lady that is pulling ranks, you know, on her friend, you know, and saying, I was the first, you know. Anybody want to guess who that is?
That's what I
hear. That's what I hear, right? All right, Bear. Bear is the first. But there's another lady here with Bear.
Yes.
You see her?
Yes.
What's your name again?
Nico.
Hi, Nikki. I got some special calls and texts to say, make sure you're on church. You don't go anywhere else, I'm going. And then something has happened in the service. About three people said to me, that lady over there in the dark places, is that Auntie Jilly? Auntie Jilly's sister? And I said, yes. You don't know this one, but it's Auntie Jilly's. I can't think of both of them, they are twin sisters.
Okay.
And her sister is beside her. And to be, could you please stand there and get everybody, you know?
Greetings.
This is Lady Vivian and her friend from Florida. Could you stand? I know Vivian. Could you just turn around and let everybody see? With Annelie is the browner one and the fairer one, and Vivian is the browner one. Alright? Thank you girls for coming. Auntie Julia asked me. I know she has been, and Anita, don't ask me on the face when I ask me. Yeah? Alright, Anita?
She tried.
Auntie Julia said she's sorry. She has called to work, so she couldn't be here with her sister, you know, so, you know, please forgive me, sister. I don't know what young she will talk about the other times, I mean, if that's up to you, yeah. In recent times, I've come across many people who are struggling and to the point of suffering, and while I burned the midnight oil, the Lord used the same theme that we are on. He actually said, address this, and I will tell you what to say. And I came into the house of the Lord, and people were just confirming the message that I had said. So let's go. It is recorded. It said Matthew chapter 6, somewhere there. You know that homework is where I come to put a homework flag, right? So you write it down. Somewhere there in Matthew chapter 6, that the Lord made a specific, is you know, when you have teachers who are concerned about your learning, they make specific guidelines. And even though they can't just hold you and put the thing in your head, I guess that they set up some things that it's easy for memory, so that you can fill in the blanks and get things done. And the model prayer is one of those. You don't agree with that, right?
Yes.
Jesus Christ, he actually said, when he pray, do it on this wise. And if we were paying attention, we would know that that is not really the Lord's Prayer.
No.
That's a model prayer.
Yes.
And if you're writing things down, write down that the Lord's Prayer is St. John chapter 17. where he represented us.
Yeah.
He testified of us. Of our parents who walk with him in the flesh. He testified of us in St. John. But in Matthew, he gave us a model and he said, you know, when you have a model, the teacher feels good about you, that you can develop on this.
Yes.
Right, teacher? Yes. if the teacher don't think you know what to do with it, the teacher will spoon feed you a little more. A good teacher's doing it. But when a model is given, it is a confidence that you will go on the right direction.
Yes.
There are many awesome statements that were made in St. Matthew 6. But this one, I borrow to quote. He said, "Our Father, who art in heaven," or some don't you say, which heart in heaven? And he said, "Hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name." And I know that people will be now, you know, trying to find out what was he saying when. Why is he emphasizing that? You know, some people would love to say, if Jesus was here, I would have been closer to him. I don't think so. Hallowed be thy name is a show off statement.
Yes, it is.
See if you can agree with me, because it will help. It will help you if you agree. It's a short statement too. Hallowed be thy name. In other words, the person you are talking to, you are recognizing, you are giving credence to the truth, not only fact, the truth that he is above everything else. When you say that name, it cannot be touched by commonality. Hallowed be thy name. You don't have a group of politicians calling this hall the hallowed hall, and then all kind of deep down and dirty and run up under the night and get fulfilled on political decisions. Hallowed be thy name, speaking to the Lord God, is really putting him in a Not that he's not there already, but in our minds, in the person who's praying, mind, I am addressing myself to the one who is far above all, everything, and everybody. And my instruction to come to present today is, the first one is to say to you, you cannot pray. We cannot pray if we do not have that consciousness that who we are praying to, his name is hallowed.
Amen.
If we are not ready to accept that this is the Lord God.
Yes,
and I remember when I was presenting on that, some people did not agree with me when I said the Lord God is the top title that you could have. They want to add Almighty and anything else you add to that, it's stepping him down a notch. You say Almighty stepping here. Yeah. Because the Lord God is the hallowed title. I don't know if I need to go over. But to say that thee, I'm not saying one and only, I'm saying only. Thee, only, owner of whatever he is Lord over. King, not only King of Kings, but the only king in that sphere, in that hallowed all. It's a hallowed entity. There is no, I don't compare him with players, which means everybody else. Because he is the only God who created and made everything that he is Lord over. So if the people that challenge or seek to want challenge can't create and make, they feel out there in the water, not even near to the shore. And there are many times that we do not have to talk too much. Sometimes we talk too much because we don't understand. When two people, when Sean and Stewie go together, not just as brethren, but as sexual partners, there are some simple questions you could ask yourself. Two or three questions and the other man done. Where is the baby going to come from? You don't bring in artificial things and come in and say, you fix this and fix that one. No. The principle of procreation is that they populate and one day come out of that. Baby, I come from out of them too, man. I don't care, you know, because anybody challenge me is Papa them children. Right. So I just come out of the way. So no blame no flash upon me. There's something that and somebody has two medical people agreed with this is that, and somebody is psychological expert. They agree with that. There are man and woman was made by God to have different not making much of what I said. Differences that enhance when they come together and produce, enhance a certain dictation towards where that child is leading. If you violate that, is like, you know, sometimes you see a crash and for a period the vehicle is running on just the two wheels on the side. Something like that. You don't have to ask if this is going to come down the road and cause a wrong one. Uh-huh. Yeah. So you know quite about these things you based and may I tell you this, gentlemen? We can help some of these people who are already gone down the road.
Yes.
But sometimes we are so harsh and religious.
Yes.
They don't even want to talk to us. Because they don't know what you're going to tell them. Jesus came in and blessed sin. But he loved the sinner. And people saw that. We come down in the sin, but the sinner needs some empathy. And there are many people who are sitting in religious garbs, struggling, suffering, in silence. And the Lord said, don't do that. Make a joyful noise. If you are at least exposed to kingdom language, use up the little you know and bawl out loud. Jesus, thy son of David, have mercy on me. Man didn't know too much, but he knew that.
Son of
David. That man was brought to the place where he knew Jesus to be described as the son of David. The triumphant entry. You know, I have a little thing with that, but let me use this. You know, when the people in Mark 11 threw their garments on the road and on the back of the coal, and Jesus was on it riding, and they made proclamations. See if you can cast your mind back to what they said. Hosanna! Yes. In the highest! And the poor had depressed him, said, blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Who cometh in the name? I think verse 9 and 10 carry 9. Who cometh in the name of our Father David? Amen. The kingdom of our Father David. In other words, and this man that was born blind would have been offended to some of those languages.
Yes, yes, yes.
So he was really beating up Jesus in a way where he said, if you are of the lineage of David, you must get the son from me. And love, family, I know that everybody is not totally committed, but this is the mindset I'd like you to get. I would like what you attach yourself to be called, that is called church, to have an individuality, have this compassion, this heart of compassion, in a way where you are not just an instructor with a big stick to boss people, hey, because you deem that they are wrong and they are sinful. But how do they get out of that? Isn't the message to help them to get out of that?
Yes, sir. That's the gospel.
What we're doing here, what are we doing here for? And even here, I think some people want to keep us, you know, comfortable inside here. So no, I don't want that to all go outside here. Some people say, oh, we're cool, I don't want to stay here. But they don't want the air conditioning. I like, so I can give the wind a mighty voice and give the wind a mighty blue. Because there are people suffering. And the thing is that there's a set of people who are suffering that is really like a canker set up, where they are religious. They are exposed to something that almost looks like church, but it is not. It is some religious setting and some secret societies, and they have their wish in there and trying to see if anything can come out of there, but it cannot come out of there because God did not create that part to populate in this part.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And so struggling and suffering is taking place. Is there a bomb in Gilead? And I don't want people to sit in churches, people who are members of the household of faith, to sit in sessions like this and start feeling guilty because probably you know a situation and you didn't deal with it properly. I don't want that. I don't want that. I don't like students who sit in the class and trying to fix something 10 years ago. I want you to make sure that you get it together so that the next move you have to make in relation to this other thing, you handle it better. Because success is the progressive realization of what I mean. It is, if you're going here and you don't reach there yet, the moment you reach up in the middle here, so you are successful. And I tell you something, some of our people walk with ultimate, what's the word? This is, whenever the company is trying, it's just extremes. Yeah, the absolute extreme, no matter what, in the middle right there. So prayer, sometimes, what is called prayer? Is a colossal waste of time. It is something to impress the listeners, the hearers, people around. But it don't move God. Because you know what God is looking for? relationship with us.
Hallelujah.
He is looking for a relationship with us. He said, you come to me, come see, and then go there. Why is it important for Jesus to say to us, recognize, put up your ID card first. Our Father.
That's right.
Who are you? You don't have to say, little son down here. You don't have to say, Mr. Nobody around here. So, him don't recognize Mr. Nobody. Can I tell you? God don't recognize Mr. Nobody. If he has been with you half an inch, you're special. So don't go like you're humble. And I said, nobody else be here on the car. So you know, we don't have time for me, God, but just do anything. And I can deal with it. He wants you to say, hear my Lord, I need you. Yeah. The sighted man. I don't call him man. The sighted man said, well, here it is, I'm not going to see. You are the authority on religious matters. But you don't know who this. I was blind, I was born blind. And the parents said, you were born blind, but we don't know how. They're afraid, they don't know how nobody children. So he was born blind, we don't know how, you know how to ask him. But the man was so brave at this time. Yeah. You know what happened, ladies and gentlemen? It's when you're suffering in silence, you belittle yourself. You belittle yourself. At least I stand up. Not you there. This one over here. This one right. Just stand up right there, sir. You see that girl? Hmm?
Yes, sir.
It's an awesome servant. For you. But up until a week ago, she never believed it. Until she made power. Sit down. When Alicia talked to me, I recognized something special in her. And I gave her a warm record. And she's doing her role. You see, sometimes because we talk, don't know ourselves too much. We don't have the gusto. The boldness. We don't know when we are honest. We don't move forward and let the chips lie where they fall. So we don't believe God to be near with us. We always just is the footmat. And the one of the Dougie Lockhart you have seen. Stay back. I recognize. But hear me, ladies and gentlemen. You are registered in the kingdom?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You know Jesus?
Yes, sir.
And you have problems?
Yes, sir.
Around you? You have issues?
Yes, sir.
And things to sign out?
Yes, sir.
Welcome to the club. Children of God. And if you just meet, you never meet Jesus quite yet, but you meet a Christian brother, a Christian sister. And we dialogue, your interest is deep, and we just talking. Eh? I'm inviting you to the banquet house. Come in and take a seat. Yeah? Because you hear the boy come up and tell him, Father, those. You come in and take a seat and have the desire to go there.
Hallelujah.
And best practice is just start batter your head. How do you choose the little one in me? And then you find big knowledge, just walk in and start present things. And your testimony get rich. I was on the call on Wednesday evening. Boy, I tell you something. When my time came to talk, I had to control myself. The expressions that were coming through
Hallelujah. My
people, my truth. I was so proud of you. Because I didn't hear people feeling after uplift, they might find something. I hear people, even in their prayer requests, it was pungent things that told me. We good. Eh? Yeah, we good. If we have a million people who are just troublemakers, don't impress me.
Amen.
But when I say quality, even little ones.
Hallelujah.
Even little ones. Because I see some things coming out of some of the little ones. I don't call about the name right now, but things are gone, yeah? Make sure you get this here. Speak the kingdom language. And the kingdom language is not a lot of words, verbose. But it's pure faith.
Glory.
Addressing yourself to exactly what Jesus said. You know when Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel. Tell them what I tell you to say. I want to draw a reference to when in Mark 11 when Jesus Christ sent the two men for the gold. The scripture definitely said, it didn't even go over what Jesus said. He said, the men, they told the men who were there sitting,
yes,
what Jesus said.
Yes.
All that Jesus, and the scripture said, all that Jesus commanded. You know why we have so much trouble? Because we're creative. We don't know where we are, so we get creative and start making up some words. And things that really impress people. Jesus never tell you to come impress nobody. Him tell us, just talk when he tell you to talk. Kingdom language comes down to us with laced with faith. And I'm saying, in my life, you don't have to be afraid of anything. You don't know the proper way to address certain things. You just go stop there and pay attention. Because properly right there with you now. You know, beside you and behind you, and right there with you, the way you get there. And when he opened your mouth, when he opened your mouth, and you start speaking the things God's going to give you, things start happening.
Hallelujah.
So I kind of have an issue with people who are suffering silently. Man like me, they used to call me impetuous. Because I said, how comes we say, is A over there, so not B, we are the one, where we're going with that? If it's A is the thing that should be done, and we are the B, then you know, is it not over going? And I said, oh, no, we're not going to make Christians out of God. Sit down and stop. And I don't sit too well, and I don't walk up with it. And I want to find out what is that going, and I tell them, I'm perfect. My friends and I were talking about some situations that I found myself in, and I'm saying, oh, I feel so free, I don't know what to do with this. Hallelujah! Oh, so quiet. No. One of the groups that I like to hear since the world is this. Ain't no stopping us now.
We're on the
road. So you know somebody to yourself. Hear me, ladies and gentlemen. We have too many sad religious people taking up space in congregations and going like them see you. Stop it! And you know who I am out against? The people who are congregations. Challenge people. You are challenging new people. Why not challenge you all at once too? What am I holding on you? And that come? Well, the man with Jesus said, he never care who was his name. Amen. He said, here is a marvelous thing. You know everything, but you don't know who this. I must disregard Jesus, who gave me sight. Because he said, you are headbound, and you will play here. Slap. I'm the good sit down before. Yeah. Huh? That the person who make that happen. You are telling me say this after the devil. You can't hear you up there. Hallelujah! Is there any warped, different person that can't be helped? Make me hear all answers. Say. And see what they, and then listen to the homework. I like that word in the next year. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. I don't see no lion in the land. And if giants are there, I just look them up and think, plead, Father, and walk away. People, most people, basically, are teachable. Most people, basically, are coachable.
Yes, sir.
If we are the extension of the only thing that makes sense, we're not going to spend little time. But you think you were hard and you tired and you can't but have to talk to one. But you know that sometimes when we start talking and drop a sleep, some of them think they're the best counseling session. Come in, we don't have time to think up no verbals. So I'm tired. Where do? And I've been kind of, and when we haven't given the answer to those, we can't give the right. And Papa comes down and wake me up and say, speak the word of kingdom. People don't understand. You know, some people just call me anytime, and some people say, I didn't call you because I thought it was too late. Decent people you are. And some people don't care, they just call anytime. And I say, what happened? What happened to you? Oh, you know? And you say, you know, and I go like that. Alright. We feel me. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. I bless the Lord. Now when you say that, and this is where these guys come from, when you say that you were glad when they say unto you, let's go to the house of God. Eh? And we took the angle that the child took this morning. Eh? You are actually saying that when Steve come here and challenge you to speak the kingdom language, if you don't know one him so, you're going to try to find out. So that glee that you had when you first came into the house of the Lord, or you were introduced to the house of the Lord, you are ready to rekindle it. And remember now, it's not only for my sake or for your sake, but it is for the sake of the house of the Lord. Every person who has interest in the house of the Lord, I am putting myself under severe pressure to be conscious enough to press for your good because of the house of God. And I'm going to repeat this. I have no instruction for Papa to build a building. When the time comes, it will happen. Right now, it is to build you, me, the people, and I am doing very well. There are people in here who I couldn't do this on myself. Just pick up yourself for what area or where you are and what you have accomplished. Amen. Amen. Sometimes when I talk to some people, because of my approach, I'm always there. They misunderstand. Because I don't see the need to be angry. Because you are the sinner, you are the thief, you are the liar. And I'm trying to show you another way. Why am I getting angry with you? If I get angry and lose my cool, I can't talk to you. Probably nice and good. So when you are hungry and ready for top me on neck, I'm quietly saying, you're still a sinner. So when somebody can't be. That's in my mind. The Papa have control over it, don't I? I live in a sin. I'm pleading with the congregation of the household of faith to be more compassionate. Amen. About people who don't have it together. I admire school teachers who are strong Christians. My friend just said, don't feel too good now. But my wife feel very good. I admire teachers who give themselves to loving people people.
Yeah.
And give themselves look after people people. I am suggesting that if you look after yourself Big Papa. You are more of an asset to be believed.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes.
Because I tell you this, ladies and gentlemen, ministry don't go about you. We're not going to pressure them on Friday. We're not going to pressure them on Friday. But then I don't want my book, I'm going to pressure them. That is the way. But ministry is loving after strong. But I am pleading with the people, the teachers in my congregation who are in the ranks of the ministry. You don't have to go to the top to burn the oil.
Amen.
You can burn it from your classroom. Burn it from your desk. Burn it from your area that you are working with. Even if you're not in charge of it, you're working with this particular area. Burn it in that. Don't suffer in silence. Especially if it is financial. Because you see that scripture said, holy capital of him one. You know what scripture is about,
yes?
Yes, sir. You sure?
Yes, sir.
All right. Holy capital of him one. That is just a tip in the bucket.
That's right.
But that's not telling you capital 1,000 years is nothing. 1,000 years. And somebody make a mistake and say, 1,000 capital of him. And then they think you're awesome. Help me, ladies and gentlemen. When you see a situation that the servant of the Lord said, Papa, hold me mindful. Keep sister.
Hallelujah.
You know, although the enemy spread over that God's apart. From the morning time. He that is for us. Just one. That's one can chase it. You ain't a clue on them, I get out of your face.
Hallelujah.
You know that when let me start by saying, the challenge, the bigger the challenges that you have to face. Is it hotter the fire that you go through for practice?
Oh yes.
Come
on.
Don't throw anything at me. Sometimes when it looks like say, boy. The wrong thing to do is to keep a pity party. You don't need a pity party. You don't have to suffer in silence and pressure yourself. Read out some kingdom language and start. Present them. Read the scripture. Remind. You don't say no, I'm not here. But it's not for you.
No.
It's for you. Remind the Lord. All the promises of the God. If you promise me that, that may hold on to. And you see how you keep going like that, it no matter what comes, when you get up, it no matter what comes from you. But just remember that if you have big things to deal with, the fire will come.
Amen? Yes, sir.
Who walk with them? Walk with them, pull them. Pull them. Don't get angry, just pour some water on that stick. Calm down. Let smoke fly. Because people needs the Lord.
Amen.
And people needs people. I have quality people at the worship center.
Amen.
Am I speaking for you?
Yes, sir.
I don't hear you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm quality people at the worship center. What are we doing? Sitting down in a comfortable hotel room, having church, and feeling good about ourselves? Well, the comfort is good. We like what God and Papa has provided for us.
Yeah.
But guess what? The people who need you don't have no such comfort. Some of them.
Sure.
Fix them. Fix them for the kingdom's sake. And for the kingdom's sake, I will help you press. You know, sometimes I come in and I want to jump the whole time. When Sean and his friend of mine the place, I want to jump on it. But Papa said, sit down, man. Sit down. Are you afraid of something? Next time. You don't know about that, you like?
Yes, sir.
Because you're not listening. If you were listening, you don't know. Eh? The challenge God prepared all his people that he's putting on the line. And that's it all was. He prepared us. I need to go out and tell them. Our job is easier than the teachers that teach school, day school. Or should I say, the teachers that teach day school don't have the easiest job as us. Because some of them are part of us. Because you have to go learn and pay to learn. Did anybody teach you? Did anybody pay you? Take care of all of your learning before you start teaching. You wish. And sometimes some things that you have to pay for yourself. Why do I have to pay for this? Because well, it's your profession that you chose. And you get in the classroom and head up out of us. And instead of them promoting Anita to principal of the top school in the country, that she deserved. Let me just make up some fire and try to have a shower. Annie, I'm done, done. I'm done, done. Don't believe some people are asleep over there, so. Anytime the devil sees it, you shoot up and down in company, really call something, because imitation. But when you stop that in the name of Jesus Christ and speak on it some kingdom language, ministry calling, please come. We ask to address that particular issue for us. I'm not going to testify for Julia, but I'm going to teach you to testify for yourself. But Julia, one testimony, or some testimony, I'm going to stop this. The people who did set up a killer, because of them, but she think they might want to hand them, whatever. Kill and touch her hand. I'm going to testify for Julia, she's not here. She'll probably have to listen to me and say, sir, I don't know what I'm saying. You don't have to sell yourself short to get what it is that the Lord offers you. And don't watch no ugly face. And then try to take what I think you shouldn't have. You understand? You say, ain't no stopping us now. We're on the move. Hey, laugh, you know. Yes, we laugh. Laugh. There are many times that I graduated to a tutorial. Now I'm straightening something. Papa said, where are you? I will throw you a tool. You think I will? I will throw you a hand. In your hand, like you have a tool team. It's not my responsibility that some people misunderstand. I mean, friends, we understand most things about me. Most of the man understand most things. I some things, I don't deny it. But no matter, we are connected.
Hallelujah.
We are connected to the Holy One.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallowed be thy name. First step, recognize whose presence, in whose presence you are. I don't have the privilege to mess around and foolish because I am in the presence and in my case I don't leave. If you love the one you win, you get to stay with the one. I fell in love with him and I'm staying. But he said, you know, he said, come down, make me have a meeting. I'm busy. Can't come, I'm dealing with the world, I'm dealing with the Lord. am making sure that the city is wide. And sometimes I'm sorry for some people conversing because I have to laugh and I recognize them. You don't understand what I'm going with. It is my belief that if it is fixable, I can fix it. And I don't believe that in still his strength, he's going to fix anything at all. But I know a man who can. And somebody has said, do you know my Jesus? Do you know my friend? Have you heard he loves you and that he will abide to you? Don't waste your time, ladies and gentlemen, trying to find out when to worship and where to worship and where. It's worship from what is the setting of your heart's condition and Papa who you seek. You surely sort things out to make it right. I want to pray today. I want to pray for people who are desiring well. You might have gone through that process already and you're at another stage, but your desire will maybe face some challenges and you want to step over that with great alacrity. You want to run over, you want to run through a troop and leap over a wall. You want the high hurdles and the pole vault look like chicken pee when it comes to spirituality. I want to pray for that. Remember what I say. Hallowed is the name of the person you are praying. So when you have that approach, you don't have no doubt or fear and trepidation as to who you're talking to. It's somebody like us, there are some people like that. I want some people to pray with me who wanna answer. You have maybe been a believer and sometimes it costs you because you only believe and God's name. But anticipating you still with it and hold on, to the purpose. In other words, the next time we meet like this, I'd like to see not only here but see some testimonies of new beginnings. When the world allows open to us, we are chopping at the bits because we have run through troops, leap over walls, and we're champions. Is there any reason why I should pray for you? Please stand up with me. And I just want to sing that because Heavenly Father,